I'm telling you, Izumi, that we are going to have problems. Many problems. Soon. You see, I have been watching the winds, the weather, the dust, the sand.
I see. Yeah? And?
Well, there isn't enough of it.
You have to be kidding me. There's more than enough sand. We have plenty of sand.
No, not the sand. The wind. The wind is lacking. It is growing limp. If my hypothesis is correct, within the next few days, these lights will begin to flicker.
Is that so? Well, maybe we should do something about it then.
What? Sacrifice a goat to the gods? No, nothing can be done here. Our doom is now.
It's not our doom. Sure, we might not have lights, but that's not the end of the world. Many of us have lived without those lights for a very long time.
I suppose it might not be the end of all things, but it certainly will be less convenient.
Yes, exactly. Less convenient, but we'll still live, won't we?
All the same, I must continue my research. There will be another way. But to rectify this issue, we'll need to work on constructing something. A backup, should the winds die down again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, good. You do that. I'm just gonna keep working here.
Good. Yes, we'll have need of those components before we're through.
Kia ora, guys, gals, and legionnaires. Rycon here. Welcome back to Let's Roleplay Kenshi. We are back with our group in the sandpit, and as you can see, we just completed construction on another well. We've been upgrading these as much as we can, trying to get them up to the next level. However, iron plates are always needed. We have actually upgraded to the latest iron plate production technology. However, upgrading this is going to require a number of iron plates that we just don't have right now. Iron plates are in hot demand, and yeah, we need more of them than we actually have right now. We use iron plates for pretty much everything. We have a really good stockpile of iron, so we're not running out of that anytime soon. We've got a lot of intake coming in, so we might even need, well, two of the level 3 iron refineries for us to really get that thing going. We are still making some steel bars over here, and I think those will start to, you know, pile up a little bit more just because we're not using them as much. We're actually working on the second level of research for that at the moment, but right now our bottleneck seems to be in the form of these iron plates. Something else that's a little bit of a bottleneck for us is our lack of wheat straw. We always need more wheat straw. Ginty, you're still just hanging outside, aren't you? Just rocking around. I think, you know, maybe word of our bar opening soon is starting to spread. So what I think we're going to do for now is remove this field here, this cacti farm that we have, and just replace it with an extra large wheat farm. So we'll go ahead and dismantle this thing, which means that we're going to get, we'll go ahead and drop those on the ground, just so we don't lose the water. That's a whole heap of cacti on the floor now. which I'm sure will get used in some form or fashion. I'm sure of it. And we're going to go and just drop down an extra large wheat field. So let's see. Right. Okay. Yeah. So you can see the crop yield from here isn't as good just because it is an arid environment. It doesn't work as well here, but it does still work. And I think that still gives us enough room to just slip through the center of that field there. And I think we actually have enough wheat kicking about right now because we can't process too much of it into wheat straw. Actually, that aspect of it doesn't take us too long. It's more here we need water and wheat straw to be able to make bread. So yeah, I guess there's that. Do we have any in our bread basket at the moment? We don't. So it's not something that's always going to happen, but yeah, we're getting there. And the construction on this is going along. We're going to need 60 wheat straw to be able to get it actually going though. So it might be a little while before we start to see
yeah, production from that. Maybe might it be better for me to start off with just a small field and work from there, but, well, what can you do? Well, what we can do is take Gary and go out on another exploration run. Not exploration, but more a selling run. We've got a whole heap of things here that we need to sell, and we probably actually have some other products that we need to shift as well. Looking into here, we have a whole heap of blades that we don't really need, so we'll go ahead and add those in. We'll maybe hold on to the junk bow. Yeah, I mean, it's a standard one. That's okay. These guardless katanas, we're going to hold on to them for now as well, just because I haven't had a good look at our team in a while to see what they're actually using. But we're going to have a look at our armor, because I think we have a fair amount here that we can start to shift. We do have those specialist grade trade leathers, which would sell for quite a lot. But right now, really, cats aren't the issue for us. We've got a lot of cats. We're doing good in that regard. We're going to take all these heart protectors, though. We'll leave some of these behind, but we're going to leave those helmets as well, because I think we can actually still make use of them. There are a number of us that don't actually have any kind of helmets on, so there's that. And finally, is there any other product that we want to take with us? No, I think that's about it. So let's jump back into our squads. We still have travelers available here. We're going to take Gary the Garu, and we are going to take, where are you, miss? You are going to be with the outer laborers, inner laborers. Why can't I find you? Ridley, there you are. Yeah, Ridley. Ridley the slow, but she's slow for now, but she won't be slow forever. Yeah. You don't need to be holding on to those, so what we're going to do is we're going to get you to just drop off the water for now. I'm going to turn off your jobs, and we're going to get the two of you to just go meet up outside town again. We're going to get you going on a little bit of a mission. Look how fast green is. God damn. I mean, I know that hivers were meant to be fast, but that is something else. I mean, his athletics is good, but like, he's got some speed. We're just running regular speed here. Just, yeah, they're some speedy boys. And we can see that there's a whole heap of harvesting that's going on here. A whole heap of failing, unfortunately. But there are 96 plants here. So that's more than enough for us to get this field up and running. Actually, speaking of that, hang on. Is that up and running? No, it's still being constructed. Okay, I was confused because I could see the other stuff. Izumi and Hobbs are still working the night and the day away. We have a huge amount of research to get through still. Izumi just making more and more electrical components for us. We've got a really good stockpile of them at this stage. Really, we're not going to need her to do that for much longer. Hammett, thank you very much for making us that straw. Rather, the flour. Now that these two are together and ready to roll, let's get them moving on back to Squin. Yes, Oh, that's maybe a survivor from the bandits that came for us. We could actually stop by the way station on the way there. They might have restocked a little bit, potentially. We are going to want to try and pick up some more food. Not so much for us, but for our animals. Our grooming herd. Yeah, we want to be taking care of them. And something else that I was thinking about for Ridley is that, well, Ridley doesn't really like to stay put. We've already discussed that. But I think we might want to try and make somewhere a little bit separate for her to live. Should she desire to settle down for a little while, or we find another job that we might be able to get her to do. I like the idea of having a shack kind of almost on the outside of town that will be hers. But looking at this, we do need to make some changes. I talked about knocking down this wall and kind of expanding. I'm almost wondering if that would be better to do on this side now. I'm thinking it could be. We've got a big stone mine over here, so there's going to be all this like noise of things chipping and all that. I think if we knock down a whole section here, that would give us some room to work with. Although it might not be enough. Because really, I want this to be a big building. I want it to be one of the biggest ones we can build. Right now, we can't build anything like super large. The largest we can probably get is a bug house, which is big. It is big, but you know, oh, hang on, that's not a bug house at all. That's the bug house. Yeah. Yeah, that's going to be one of the largest structures that we can make. We've made the longhouse before, we've already got that. The L house is also pretty big, and is kind of your standard setup for bars, but
Yeah, a bug house could be quite cool as well. And you can see it really does kind of stand above the rest here. I am not so certain what we want to do on that yet. We don't have to make up our minds yet because it's going to take a whole heap of stuff to be able to actually do it. And we've completed some research. Oh, can we talk to you? Nomad animal trainer. Trader, rather. What do you have? You have a pupper. Oh, and a goat. Well, we could add to our herd, couldn't we? Yes, we could. We already have a goat friend. So we could add a... we could add another. We do have Barker. I like the idea of us having attack animals. You know, I feel like they could work out quite well for us. So, Sand, how about we head on out there? We know that we can't trade items to these people, but we can trade good, hard-earned cats. And look at that. Those two are already up there as well. So as soon as Sand has had this discussion, we'll go check in on Ridley and our mate Gary to see exactly how they're doing. I don't think we're going to need any pack beasts. Not for the foreseeable time. Let's see. Show me what you got. Okay, let's see. Right, don't think we're going to need a bull. So you do have a bone dog and you have a goat. I think we're going to pass the goat up this time. I think we are just going to go for the bone dog. We got another female bone dog. We're going to go ahead and purchase you. Okay, now what is your name going to be? Okay, so I have settled on Rosie. As Rosie was one of my childhood doggos, I feel like Rosie will be a fine addition to our team. Now, Rosie, where do we want you to live? You could help support Dogme. Dogme could just have like this herd of growing, a growing pack. Go ahead and bodyguard Dogme. I think that'll go fine. Yeah. We've got quite a few now, don't we? We do have quite a few. So, Rosie, you're going to go jump down here. We're going to put you with the others. And you're going to be perfectly fine. Sand, you're going to go jump back inside. Excellent. Now, let's go check in on our travelers. All right, they actually made it straight into the bar itself. I love it when Gary accidentally makes it inside somehow. Just this huge Garu just standing in the bar. Welcome, customer. Yes, we have a very hungry Garu with us. We're gonna have to trade with you, buddy. Let's do some business. Let's see what you got. You got nothing. You got nothing, kid. Although you do have funds, that's good. You have funds that we can work with. Okay, well, let's go ahead and start selling off some of these, stuff and things. Just clear out that inventory space a little bit here, and we can get away with selling most of this, but yeah, we're gonna be pretty well off by the time we come back from this. Now, it could be worth us keeping a sleeping bag always with Gary. I think that probably is the case. There's nothing else that we want here at this stage, so we'll take these two and we'll go across to here. So we could get some iron plates. There's going to be many for us to get in here. And it is tempting, but I'm confident we can get that production up. This is kind of just a shortcut. Damn it, you know what? I think we are going to get some. But I think we are going to... yeah, we're still going to have funds left over. A lot of funds left over. So we're going to continue on with our group now. I mean, it's such a short run down. I'm tempted just to send them back. You know what? That's what we're going to do. And then we're going to go to Squin. Sure, we can do that. We can do that. We can make that work. All right, head back down real quick, like, team. So we're going to get them just to jump back into this position here. And we'll see how they're doing. Now, we do have some issues outside here. We need some more lights, don't we? So let's get lit, yo. I'm gonna stop. Just at any time, know that you can stop me as well. You have the power. So, with our lights, we are going to add not the searchlight, the spotlight? No. The spotlight, yes. The less intense light for us to have here. We're going to add another one here as well. And looking at these walls here, we're going to add one here and add one there. That should be a nice amount of light, and it will keep this area just looking good. You know, I feel like having those lights on the inside just brings our town to life a little bit. We might even put some on this side here. Actually, we don't have any on the outside yet either, do we? Well, I guess we've found a use for our components, haven't we? Yes, we have. Now, there we go. We got there in the end. So I don't think we're going to need any extra there, but we will want some here on the inside. And it looks like we can kind of only really do it on the outside there. That's on the outside? Yes, it is. Okay. Well, that's unfortunate. I guess we can only do one. No, we've got two. They're just in different places. That's fine. I'm okay with that. Let's get constructing. So everyone should be running into action there. Hong just having a little bit of a chill out, which means that we don't have any animal skins to work on, or our leather storage is just incredibly full, which is usually the case. Although, no, it's not at this stage, because I think we've got, yeah, two very full buckets. Buckets of leather. Thank you for getting to work so quickly here, team. And it looks like we're halfway there with this wheat straw construction. Slowly but surely, we are getting there. And ready to harvest, needs water, growing. Okay. Well, stick to it, team. You're going to be able to get this thing done. I think as soon as something does need harvesting, they seem to prioritize the harvest over getting water to things, which I think is fine, because there is only so long you have that window to harvest things before it's gone. You start losing plants. And just looking at the number of cacti that we have here, we're doing pretty well for ourselves, I have to say. Yeah. We're making life in the desert work. I'm happy with that. And Firebone, surprisingly enough, is staying pretty busy, which means that we are producing a fair amount of food. And that we are. We have many of these dust witches. We can see that this is possibly the food with the highest unpleasantness to nutrition in the world. So dry, probably a big contributor to desert suicide. So, I mean, it's, you know, they're not the nicest sandwiches in the world. And they're just incredibly dry. But I feel like it's better. It's better than the chew sticks. It's a step up above. This is the best we can do with nothing but cacti, which is just, water and mashed cactus. Fantastic. See, our food's fine. It's more just our others. Oh, you guys are back. Fantastic. Well, we'll let time keep on rolling. I'm going to try and get in the habit of just letting time just do its thing rather than pausing all the time. So we've got a whole heap of iron plates here, Gary. Let's go ahead and drop them into here. Fantastic. I don't think there was anything else that we needed to take with us, was there? No, we're looking good. Okay, team. We're going to continue on towards Squin. Good travels. Best of luck to you. Watch out for those bone dogs. You got this, team. You got this. Remen, I've been impressed with. He's been working very hard on these steel bars, creating many for us. Doing an excellent job. We can actually upgrade this at this stage, but, not quite yet. Oh, before anything else, bloody steel plates are already going to other things, aren't they? We need 13 to upgrade this, which we should be able to do. Now, let's hope that we have 13 around. If we don't, I'm going to take stuff apart. We're just going to tear it apart. I would have to think that most of them still have some of those plates in their inventory. Otherwise, we can get them from other places. Like, look, we've got two just chilling out here. There'll probably be some, just chilling out here. We have been making some bolts, which we seem to be doing a good job at. We've got some regulars now, and those regulars means that we're going to be able to give Green some of those regular bolts, because at this stage he's just been using the junk bow, but now we can deck him out with the spring bat because he has regular bolts. So can we reach that from here? I think we might be able to. We can, fantastic. So let's just go take a whole heap of those. And let's look at our weapons storage. Store that in there. Just go ahead and rearrange that a little bit, and we'll take one more of those. We'll take them all. Screw it. We'll take them all. There you go, Green. You're all set. And we are... Yeah, we're still short. Oh, it's building materials. Oh, that's fine. We've got heaps of building materials. Yeah, we're good there. And it's pretty much... It's nearly the whole team working on this. Just everyone getting involved. The whole cast. Working on making this thing. And it's looking like it's pretty big. And I don't know whether or not it is going to require a worker now. Because sometimes they do become automated when you get them to high enough of a level. We're onto robotics now with Hobbs. He's been researching up an absolute storm. So much so that I'm probably going to forget some of the things that we've researched. I think that was ore drill 2 he was working on. So that means that we'll be able to upgrade this to a greater degree. No, it was not. Perhaps it is, we just can't upgrade it. So let's have a look at the ore mine. Nope, it's still just level 1. That's fine. I suppose. Yeah. Let's actually have a look at that research. It's been a little while since we've had a look. Robotics, we're onto harpoon turrets next. Very nice. Very nice. I guess the only unfortunate thing is that we can't see the research that we've done before, so I guess if I miss it, I miss it. We haven't had anyone training for a little while, but it's probably going to be worth us getting our team back to that before long. We did have Saru getting trained up. Melee attack of 11. We could probably give that a little bit higher, Saru, so let's get you back onto the training dummy. And we were training up some turrets. Actually, Sand, how is your assassination skill? It's already high enough that we can't do anything with it. That's fine. But yeah, turrets. We are going to want others to be turreting. Hong is already more than good enough. Park, we're obviously not going to use you on turrets at all. But looking at our inner, so Kidgy and Firebone, for example, we want them to be on turrets because they're a little bit more fragile. And I think they would just do better being safe behind the wall, so we'll take them away from their jobs just for now to go work on those. We've still got a very, very busy group here to check in on our runners, and they have, I have no idea where they are. Oh, wow. We're not even fast forwarding. They got some speed going on right now. They're nearly at Squin. Fantastic. Well, they should be there. Right around when the sun is ready to rise. So we'll be able to sell off all of those goods and maybe look at purchasing some other things. One thing that we do need, and that I've been neglecting, it's just regular research books. We need a whole heap of regular research books for us to be able to work on some other research that just requires the regular ones rather than all this strange stuff. Ruka is just chilling out at the stage. Oh, because, of course, the iron refinery is not in operation. Although, interestingly enough, she has kept that job, even though this is a entirely new machine. Well, I guess it's the same, but different. Where are we at? Iron plates, 32 or 35. We can definitely do that. We can make that work. There's none in there at this stage. We haven't collected them from outside. Let's just go take these two here and just drop them on the ground. Like magic, we have some iron plates for them to be able to grab. That will mean that we probably need some more for the lights that are popping up around here. But actually, saying that, they managed to get quite a few of those done while I wasn't looking. Good job, team. Good job. Yeah, it's nice and lit inside. And we have our first one here going. Good. Good, good, good. The whole place is becoming a lot more lively at night, which is what we want. And once it gets to 6, we'll check back in on our other team to see how they're doing. But with this last little bit of construction done, just like that, it's working. And look, we don't need to have a worker. This machine is fully automatic. It just makes iron plates for us, which means we're gonna need another one. Yeah, and that also means that Ruka, you're out of a job. So what are we gonna do with you, Ruka? Well, Ruka, you have fantastic laboring skills, just unbelievably good. So we definitely still want you to be helping us out here, that's for sure. But with what? But with what? We don't actually have anyone working on that right now, on our raw stone. So let's maybe get you helping out with that. As I think we can have two people working on this at any one time. Yeah. So I just don't think we have anyone there. Oh, look at that Barker running along to eat that dried meat. We're going to need a lot more dried meat. God damn, these animals. They're difficult to keep fed. Actually, you know what? They can probably eat chew sticks, right? Yeah, sure they can. Sure they can. Okay, let's go ahead and steal someone for a second, Park. I'm going to use your backpack for this, buddy. We're going to grab all the chew sticks there. And we're going to give them to the animals because I'm sure that they will still enjoy them all the same. Wonderful. I think we as humans can still eat from the troughs as well. I think. I'm not 100%. I'm pretty sure. We've had no more wheat straw come in. That's okay. That's doable. A lot of cacti though. A lot of cacti, so much so that we can probably look at swapping some of the fields out, because we've got 39 just chilling out in here at this stage. So our bottleneck is still wheat, so I'm thinking we are going to need more wheat fields. This hemp really hasn't been working out too well for us, just because it's got such a low... Oh, well, actually, right now, it just needs water desperately. As I'm sure a lot of this place does. We've got some going on. We need to go ahead and start upgrading the rest of these. And for that, it requires iron plates. Thankfully, only two. So we should be able to achieve that before long. With this thing just doing what it does, which is create iron plates on the fly. I can kind of see us having a whole line of these set up. We might change things around slightly. We might have like an iron refining area that is set up just for that purpose. Yeah. Well, we're nearly at time. So Ridley and Gary, we can actually go into the bars. So let's do that to start with. And hey, look at that. Home sweet home. Well, what's left of it? There is actually still a fair amount left of it, surprisingly enough. But yes, we're going to go ahead and start in the bar. Work our way down towards that. Oh, shush you. We've given you a whole heap of business. Ridley, go ahead and get trading here. I wouldn't try and mess with Ridley there, though, my dude. Alright, that's a whole heap of food. Probably good enough for us for now. And Gary, let's get you trading. And that's it. Actually, no, we can trade one of the power cores. Brilliant. Done. Okay, and Ridley, I think it's probably going to be best for us to do a little bit of a transfer here. Actually, you know what? You keep what you got. Keep what you got for now. We'll just chuck the rest in Gary's. But I'm glad that they have been able to make it here with seemingly not too much trouble. We didn't see them flashing at all, meaning that they didn't get interrupted by anyone on the road. So maybe the roads are getting a little bit safer. Maybe all of that combat that we've been doing has been helping. Let's keep time rolling. So Gary, we're going to go to you first of all. We're going to purchase all of that good old food, and then we're going to go get selling. We'll start with the power cores again. There we go. That is us, and I think it should be time enough now. Well, we're very, very close to it being time enough. There we are. Fantastic. So I think we probably are going to try and buy some extra things from the marketplace. We don't really need to buy any armor, and I'm pretty sure that we have already bought all of the potential blueprints that we can get from here. Let's see. Armored rags, samurai cloth pants. Already known. We're missing the Drifter's leather jacket, which I think is potentially a good one for some of our crossbow users. Yes, indeed, it does actually give them better crossbowing skill. So I'd be tempted to get that, if not for just being able to deck out our range combatants with something that's going to give them an actual bit of a benefit. You know what? I feel like we're doing well enough right now. We'll go ahead and purchase this. We'll keep the sheck on our good side. So we're looking for Drifter's leather jacket. Boom. Pick it up, thank you. And we'll go ahead and just sell what we have. a whole heap of this, a whole heap of that. And we're looking pretty good after all of this and that. Pretty good indeed. All right, Ridley, let's go ahead and learn that research. Or rather, just click on the meat wrap. And with you, we are going to carry on towards the marketplace to see if we can pick up some extra supplies before we leave town. We're going to be a little bit weighed down as we're running back, but we can make it. These two travelers together. Let's see. It's been a while since we've been here, and it's actually the first time for Ridley. Okay, so what are we going to purchase from you? We could pick up some more. I think we literally always need a fabric, so we're going to pick up as much fabric as we can. We're going to pick up some cotton, even some hemp. What else are we going to grab? I think the wheat straw is going to work out for itself just fine. Oh, that's right, books. We need to bring back a whole heap of books. Let's not forget about that. We're going to pick up some iron plates just because they're cheap. And I think that's us done here. Yeah. That's us. Let's carry on towards the explorer's place before we leave, because this is where we're going to get the majority of our research books. I nearly forgot. It's quite possible that I would have just completely missed that. So go ahead and jump inside, Ridley, and we'll see how many we're able to purchase from here. And if there's any new maps as well. We're always in need of new places to explore. Ooh, okay. Town of Ninjas. We'll take that. And we've got another one. Lost Library. Right, we'll take both of those. And we are going to take 25 books. It'll cost us a bit, but, well worth all of that. Fantastic. Ration packs. Very tempting. You know what? We'll go ahead and pick them up as well. A good deal done. Now, we've come out with a profit after all of that, and that was selling most of our really, really good stuff, so we can't do that every single time. But it's enough to keep us going for a little bit longer. We're staying afloat, and that's the main thing. Alright, you two run on back in. Oh, we've got some trouble, but it's trouble that we're not so concerned with. They're going to be able to take care of this easy. Ridley did get hit in the crossfire there, but she's going to be fine. As are the Sheik that are just taking down these bandits. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Alright team, how are we doing back here? Things are looking good, they're looking positive. We have iron plates in the output here, very nice. How's the training going? Do we need to stop you? Melee attack is 12, you can get a little bit more. Firebone turret is at 10, and is this a level 3? This can take you all the way up to 30 actually, interesting, wow. A lot higher on the turrets. Very nice. And 19 on the assassin dummy. So if we can get it up to level 3, we might be looking pretty good with that. Well, I'm on board with that. Okay, how has this water been going? That next well is now level 3. Okay, well, we're just going to keep on upgrading these. We'll do them one at a time, just because I think that's the smart thing to do. Building materials, not an issue. But everything else, a little bit more so. We haven't had anyone working this in a while, which is, well, not so concerning. We do have some semi-big projects on the horizon, though, so we are going to need a decent amount of building materials. So I'll just need to go through our inner crafters and figure out who exactly is meant to be using that. Okay, so really no one was actually doing it as their main job, so Ruka is now going to be doing that for us. Helping us out with that. Hong, we might be able to get you helping us out with engineering as well, just because Hong doesn't have too much to do currently. Although in saying that, Hong is actually a pretty proficient armorsmith now, so once we have more resources, we'll be able to make more armor. But again, we are just lacking that good old fabric. Yeah, we need to just expand our hemp making process to a whole nother degree. Or find somewhere nice and close that we can buy a whole heap of fabric. Swamp Village, maybe. I don't actually think that they had like a proper marketplace there though, so I don't think that's going to be a proper option for us. Oh, you know what I forgot? Well, for one, I forgot that these two are incredibly separated. I don't like that. Ridley, do you have a midpack on you? You don't. Well, apologies. But you'll be feeling better before long. Let's see where these locations are meant to be. So we have one that's actually pretty close, an unknown tower. Well, I say pretty close. It's not close, but, you know, it's somewhere. If we make it to the hub, we could make it across to there. That's a little bit of an exploration that Sand might be able to do. It could be good for a solo Sand. And I know everyone freaks out about solo missions, but Sand, being the legit ninja that he is, I feel like we stand the best chance at pulling off a solo mission like that. Now, I won't be splitting people out all over the place, but it's a potential option, you know, it's something that we can look at exploring. And then the other that we had is all the way down here. We have some runes. Now, I would hate if that tower was just like, it's just an empty tower. That would suck big time, but it looks like there's a pathway almost that leads up towards it, which is slightly ominous. And then we have a way station and a tiny settlement along the way. If I was to send Sand, would I send Sand and dog meat? I feel like that would give them a chance to fight off anything that might try to attack him. But in saying that, how is your stealth at the moment, dog meat? Your stealth is... it's okay. It's okay. Could be a lot better than that. Yeah. Could be a lot better. Hobbs, you're researching up a storm, my friend. You're doing a fantastic job. We love your work. And we have more of this complete. Sand is just chilling out. He can't work on any armor crafting at the moment either. So he's primarily just going to be focusing on upgrading whenever that time arrives. We're going to be upgrading this one as well. And I think at this stage, we're safe enough that we can just start fast-forwarding through. And I didn't actually even realize that you were back here, buddy. Damn it, they made it back here really fast. I guess Ridley just went straight back into jobs, no? Oh no, Ridley is still... Wow. Yeah. You had a bit of a head start there, Gary. A bit of a head start. Just saying. Okay, so looking at the food, we're going to give all of this meat here to our buddies. We're going to put the meat wraps inside for now, but we might look at changing that. There isn't anyone inside at the moment, so we can't actually see inside. Ziff, where are you going to go? How about you pop inside, just so we can see what we're doing here. Okay, so back to Gary. There we are. Let's see, Bud, we're going to go get you to drop off that food. And we'll drop off all the rest. Okay, and checking back in with our research here, we have added in some new research options with the books that we had with us here. So we've got this harpoon turret spotlight fitting, the stone refining upgrade, assassin training 3, battery capacity 4, and battery power 4. All kinds of upgrades that Hobbs is working on, and he's doing a fantastic job at that. We're going to keep time flowing here. Chaku, oh, you're working this. Fantastic. So I did drop everything else off, so we should see some more fabric reappearing. And having a look at our travelers here, we need to go back to our squads and just divvy them back out. So Ridley, you're going to be jumping back in with the inner labor crew. You are using what exactly? I am actually uncertain. Gary, you're just going to chill up the top there. We'll go ahead and check on Ridley real quick. You are using... Yeah, you're farming with us. Fantastic. Okay, that's good. How close are we here? We're pretty close. Just need some more iron plates, which are being grabbed. Fantastic. Nearly done. I'm thinking we're just going to need a whole heap more of these wells. Just so many more. I'm glad that they just don't require anything from us other than, of course, power. Power is something that we're going to need to keep our eye on because you can see that it is fluctuating a little bit here and our battery charge is starting to drop. We've been lucky in that we've just had this one battery bank here. It has been getting upgraded though. As we've been improving our battery research, it's been kind of getting better. You can see that there is not a whole heap of wind now at all. Actually, it just completely dropped off. It just completely dropped off now. So for the first time, we might actually be losing our charge altogether, which that sucks. Yeah, that'd be hilarious. The second that I started focusing on it, that's when things go wrong. I mean, that sounds like it's about right, though. Yeah. It's a very, very hot day. We can see a whole heap of just this heat wave in the distance there. And, yep, that battery charge is dropping down. And we're just left with this minute amount of power. So everything is slowly going to stop working. And that's where we'll notice that, you know, there is issues like efficiency. 6%. It's not very efficient at all. This will be barely working, just slowly turning over. So we need to have an option for when this happens. We did have some research for a heavy generator. I think it was heavy generator theory, something that we could look into. It does require larger and more powerful. I don't think we need an incredibly powerful generator. I mean, it's tempting, and it gives us something to do with our advanced science books, but we can kind of hold on to those. I feel like we need them. Yeah, tech level 5 is 8 science books, and it's possible for us to get that. We're just going to need to go back out there into the world again, which means that sand is probably going to have to leave before long. We've got both Rain and Obelim working this at this stage. Ruka? Because I think this is a manual process, is still do this, but it's manual, but it does use assistance. It still uses power. So what are we going to do in the meantime? Well, let's have a look at our power generation that we can do. So this is why originally I thought the Corpse Menace was a generator of some kind, because it is underneath power. But we'll have a look and see what else we can make. Just a generator. So for a generator that runs on biofuel. So biofuel is going to use our crops. Now, we can add a number of different crops here, but unfortunately there aren't any for cacti. It's almost like they knew that we had a whole heap of cacti and they would want to try and turn it into something else. We don't have a massive amount of wheat straw, but we have some that would be able to produce some fuel with. The other option is that we just go purchase some fuel, and it's not gonna cost us too much to do that. Yeah. Because even adding more of these isn't going to help. The other option, though, and that this is a possible option for us, is to just deal with this for now, but expand our wind that we are utilizing at the moment. Really, really, really expand that into something a lot larger. I reckon we could do that. I kind of like the way that it's all spread apart right now. See, if we added another one, for example, we could improve our battery storage that we're using at the moment. I'm in favor of doing that. And you know how before I was talking about knocking down the walls? I think what we'll do, rather than actually knock down the walls, is that we'll treat this like an inner bailey. We'll create another outer wall with sections that you can kind of go through, gates within the city. That might screw with things a little bit. We'll see. I might just leave them as openings. That depends. But what we do need, for sure, is a proper place to actually have all of our batteries in. A battery house, if you will. So let's have a look. We've got space here, and that could be the kind of space where we want to place that thing down. So we're just going to want a small shack. And it looks like we can fit one in here pretty nicely. Yeah, so let's see. What's going to be the best way for us to actually fit this in? We've got options. We can actually put it in here, next to where Remen's working as well. I just don't want it to obscure too much. It's going to be too close to that well, I think. On an angle here does kind of work, though. Yeah, that's working. It's accessible in that position. And once we have that done, that's going to actually free up some space into here as well. So what we'll do is we'll build the batteries in there, and then we'll have a look at dismantling this one here. It's a lot of failing going on there, folks. I hope you're getting better at farming. Let's actually just check in on Lo, who's been doing farming for a while. Yeah, 52. It's pretty damn good. Ridley, how are you looking? It could be better. That's a whole heap of hemp that we're dropping there, folks. And I think they're running that inside here. Or, no, they were running to get water. Well, at least that's kind of working. Not really working, because our power is terrible right now. We just need a good windy day. They made this incredibly quickly. Incredibly quickly. So, let's have a look and see if we can get some things placed. Will I be able to see inside? We will see. We can. Fantastic. Okay, so battery banks. This is where we want all of our banks to be. It just requires iron plates and electronic components. So let's start placing these things down. We want to have a little bit of space in between them. We might be able to go for... Well, how exactly do we want to do this thing? I think we could go for three along the back. Alright, I'll tell you what, I'm going to get these things placed, and I'll return in a moment. Okay, this is what I've gone for, I know it's very, very tight, but I'm hoping that there'll be just enough room for them to get around to the back there. I'll find out very quickly if they can't. Actually, in saying that, they can kind of build from here, so I think it'll be fine, but it looks at the very least like they can move around there. Wow, I've really done this inefficiently, haven't I? They're going to build them all individually. Ah, dear. If only they kind of worked from the back to the front. What's going to happen here is that none of these are going to get constructed, and then they're all going to be ready at the same time. It's pretty much how it's going to work. Well, at least we can get the major things in. We have heaps of electronic components, so all of those are going to get placed down. So there's that. And then it's just the iron plates from that point on. And I think we might still have some left over. No, we do not. We don't really need to have these bolts kicking about any longer. So we're going to remove that, and we're going to drop that down there. Like so. And construction continues. Hobbs has nearly completed advanced harpoonery. Very good. That's going to take a little while longer for us to get up and running. But it's another nice, beautiful windmill for us. Welcome. A very, very welcome. How is Gotega the Great doing? You doing all right, Goat? Oh, you are tiny. You are so small. That is adorable. You're an adorable little goat. You're just having a munch. Having a munch while Oren and Ziff work on the ore drill. Just getting a ridiculous amount of ore for us, actually. And saying that, though, yeah, the efficiency is terrible right now because we have no power. Yeah, we got a ways to go. Sand, looks like you're trying to get that constructed, and we actually have our first one up and running. Yeah, it looks like we're going to be able to do this easy as. They can actually access them perfectly fine. Exactly what we want to see. Excellent. Now, we might not have been able to place that like that originally, but I do have a mod that kind of allows us to place things a little bit better, and it does allow us to build like on slopes, for example. So, should we wish to expand all the way out here, which we probably won't be doing, we've got lots of flat ground to look at here. We can do that. I'm just kind of more looking at all of this region here. I'm just thinking, yeah, that's all going to be farmland for us. So our farming district is going to be this whole area here. I can kind of see us just expanding that wall out to just encompass this entire space. So that's what we're leaving that for. But everything else around the front here is going to primarily focus on industry, crafting, and entertainment. Of course, we need to have our very big and large punchy gar. We can start off with a smaller building, though. I mean, I feel like I'm tempted to wait until we get, like, a really big building, but we could start with a smaller one and then, you know, move everything into the big one. It might just be a whole heap of work for nothing, because we'll need to redesign everything when we get a bigger building, so I might just hold off that for now. But things seem to be going kind of okay here. We've got all of those electronic components in. We just need those steel plates, or rather iron plates, which we're not going to get while the wind is like this. So it's just one of those days. Occasionally we're going to get a very non-windy day where it's just still and calm and there are no dust storms. Yeah, didn't think I'd be wanting a dust storm, but there we go. So sand, I don't think we can get you sitting still for much longer. So we might need you to go back out again, my friend. Now, are we going to go out with the large backpack, or are we going to bring the stealthy backpack? I think we're going to go large, purely just because we can fit a lot more in there than we can in the large thieving backpack. Oh, I thought you were going to go back to work for a second then. Let's actually look at dropping some things off. You do have that you can get rid of for the time being. If we are going to send you out on an expedition, we'll need to make sure that you have food to go with you. So take the 3 ration packs. Might be a little overkill, might not. We'll find out soon enough. We need you to drop that. And we'll go ahead and drop off one of these medical supplies just into the storage there. Now that's Sand pretty much ready and rearing to go. Everything that he will need to be out on the road. So let's go into our squads. We're going to grab Sand, and he's going to be traveling. Now, is he going to travel alone? Yes, I think he's going to slip out before Ridley knows that he is gone. As Ridley, we know, likes to travel, hates to stay in one place for too long. But Sand, this is something that Sand will need to do by himself. It isn't too far. Sand is incredibly fast. Incredibly fast, he says, as he puts him on jog. What we're going to want to do is maybe stop off and swim first, go to the hub, and then go to the way station. I think like that might be the best way to do it. Although really, actually, you know what? There is something in the hub for us. And that is the Shinobi Thieves. It's been a long time since we've visited them, and they can have some really good stuff. And just look at this man run. He is lightning. Well, he's pretty quick. He's not going to be as quick as a Hiver with all the athletic skill that he has, but he's pretty fast. This is one fast guy. Let's actually have a look and see how he is speed-wise. Yeah, he's running fast. +2, 27 miles per hour. Fantastic. Look at him go. He's running so fast, he's moving into the ground. Yeah, so he's going to be busy for a while with that, which means that we can stay focusing on our home. And we can see that Park is actually back to making blades with those iron plates, which, you know, I feel like we might need those iron plates elsewhere, buddy. So I feel like I'm going to put a pause. Let's put a pin in that for now. Yeah, we'll put a pin in that. And we'll just go take those iron plates and drop them out for now. And we'll let some of this other construction continue. We're going to have, look at that, the battery charge that we have now, 720. Pretty good. Pretty freaking good. Rain, run here for a second, just see how the place is looking. Yeah, that's not even it finished. We're going to have a ridiculous amount of charge. So I don't think we're going to need generators when all is said and done, because we're just going to have a whole heap of power to run with. We could probably survive an entire day. No problem. No problem. All right, we're halfway to Squin. Sand is making good progress. As are we. Just not quite enough yet. Still going to be slow going. Hey, at least the copper intake is still going to be really good. Spot and Hanbu smashing away at this thing. Thankfully, it hasn't degraded at all. There's still a whole heap of it. And we're going to see that popping up a whole heap because we should be smashing through lots of these. How is our copper at the moment? Looking pretty good. We've got another one over here as well. Yep, our iron is nearly at capacity. Yeah, our intake's looking really, really nice. And that's even more. Oh no, Kenshi, you're stuck. Oh no, you're not. Yay. But yeah, 1200. We're going to be fine. Stubbs, how are you doing, buddy? Look, I promise you, Sand is going to come back with a treat. Just you wait. Just you wait, buddy. You're not going to have to hold out for too long without that arm of yours. Ah, bud. Well, we've got heaps of food in here. Our animals will be happy. We've got Barker and Rosie attempting to follow Dogmeat, but Dogmeat is much faster. Dogmeat the Pack Lord. Keeping an eye on all of our yappers. Sand, is that Squin you're getting close to, my friend? I think it might be. Or you've probably already passed it by. No, this seems Squinish, and indeed it is Squinish. We can see it right in front of us. I think you're going to go straight through there. And it's because Squint is built in such a place that it's, you know, you're going to have people running through there. What is that building up here? I think that might be Dust Bandits, a camp of theirs. Quite possibly. You just power on through there, buddy. Do what you do best. And, well, if we have power come nighttime, I'm actually looking forward to seeing the place because we should have most of these lights completed. Well, I say should. Looks like there are some. Oh no! Hey, look at that! They've all been completed, apart from the ones on the outside. For whatever reason, people seem to have trouble with these ones. So we might need to encourage a little bit of extra work to be done on those. So let's see, who's sitting up the top there at the moment? Who's just chilling out? Our farmers, pretty much our farmers. They're all just chilling out for now. Miu, can you assist us with this? You don't have any building materials. I think that's a fib. We need electronic components and iron plates. We can definitely do that. I think this might be one of those manual things. We just need to manually get people to get the stuff. Yeah, okay. So we need two electronic components, among other things. So let's go ahead and take one, two, and let's go take some iron plates. From where, you might ask? Well, that's a great question. That is a great question. From nowhere is the answer. From nowhere. And that's why you don't have any bits and bobs, because, yep, we actually don't have any right now. Hey, look at that, the copper's been placed in here. It's only 8 iron plates, it's not too bad. Not too bad. Green, you madman, look at you go. What is our cacti looking like at the stage? Oh, we're full. And that one's going to be full soon as well. Yeah, we can definitely convert some of these cacti fields into wheat straw. Definitely. I think these two right in the center here, we're going to go ahead and convert those. So let's take these 13 candi. Cacti. God damn it. And we're going to go ahead and dismantle. Yes. And we're going to look at this one here, which is being harvested. You know what? Let it be harvested first. This one up here has been done. So we're going to go back into food. We're going to go to... Not food, apparently. We're going to go to farming. And we're going to go to our wheat farm. Wheat farm. Don't talk like a child. It's a wheat farm. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and place this here. We are going to start with small, just so we can actually get the thing placed, because we still seem to be having trouble getting this one going. I feel like that was a big mistake. Let's actually just go and dismantle this one. Oh, hang on, no, we can downgrade. Yeah, there we go, downgrade, and go downgrade one more time, and we have a working farm. Look at that. I think it might have destroyed some of the wheat that was there, but, you know, that's okay, right? That's fine. Hong, what are you doing, bud? Just chilling? Yeah, you're just chilling. That looks like it's nearly ready. Yep. Soon to be harvested. Advanced harpoonery. Harpoonery is a fantastic word. Especially the advanced kind. Sand, where are we at with you, bud? You are away. Wow, you're almost at the hub already. Sometimes... Yeah, I guess I shouldn't be surprised. He's just got constant momentum, this man. There's no stopping him. Now, hopefully we'll be able to get some good things here. I have learnt from my prior mistakes of selling things to the shinobi thieves. We don't really want to sell to them. We just want to purchase. Yeah. The things you learn in Kenshi. The things you learn. We're nearly at 80 athletics. So we've got some pretty good speed. There are still going to be some things in the game that we cannot outrun. Death being one of them. Death comes for us all in Kenshi. But, you know, at least for now, we can outrun most of the animals that might try and eat us. Alright, Sand, let's see. What do we have here? You, good sir, let's see what you have. You have Ninja Rag Blueprint. Which... are these here? Meh. Nothing too great. I mean, the blackened chain shirt is very expensive, but is quite good.
although we can see that it still has a negative effect to your stealth. This is specialist grade though, so it's really freaking good. This is the best money can buy. It is. It is. Indeed it is. But, I'm not gonna part with that many cats.
No, we're gonna be a little stingy on that.
But we're gonna continue on towards this way station. And this is an area of the world that we haven't explored yet. So whenever we have that, we generally want to explore that with Sand. So even though he's gonna be moving a little faster, moving and grooving, we're gonna try and stick with him. And we can kind of see the pathway that he might be taking once he crosses this. Actually, there isn't much of a river there. It does start down that way. I think whenever we come to these areas, it's always very reminiscent of his beginning. Just being out here with Park, stealing from Holy Nation Farms. Yeah, we've come a ways since then. We sure have. I mean, that's that. That's one thing. We have discovered a holy military base along the way, though. Probably not great. And I'm actually glad that we're taking a wider route around. It looks like we might have to go all the way onto the other side of these canyons to try and work our way up there. Might be a little bit more difficult than I anticipated. Yep, well, there you go, Sand. He's turning around. I think he is going to go up that way. It was just his AI couldn't quite find that path originally. But that should be it up here, if I had to guess. And that it is, which is going to take us straight towards the Holy Military Base. Somewhere that we can at least scout out, see what their numbers are like, and, well, if they have any prisoners there, we might be able to go for a bit of a prison break. It is nighttime, of course, and seeing as it's nighttime, we're going to have a very quick squint back at our base to see how it is looking at night, and it is looking damn nice. We still don't have those front lights completed yet, but just looking at this place from a distance, I mean, it looks pretty impressive. It's definitely got a footprint, that's for sure. Very cool, team. Very cool. Now, Sand, my buddy, my pal, looks like you're still trying to find a way, and I think you've gotten confused here. I think that's what's happened. So let's he's running back down the hill, which we don't want him to do. I think possibly when we go back and forth, it might just upset his AI a little bit here. So we're gonna help him through these hilltops. All the while, we'll let this think about life for a moment. All the while, we need to stay very aware of patrols on these roads, because with that base being up there, I could very well see them sending troops down this way. Just nice and easy, Sand. Let's go ahead and step that up to second speed, and we'll go ahead and crest the top here. Hey, at least the wind is kicking up over here. Gotta hope it's doing the same back at home. Alright, let's see. Oh, okay. We're looking alright. The base is a little bit further away. It's all the way up there, actually. And we are going close enough that I think we are going to have a look at it. And we can see that the wheat farm has been constructed. I'll need to make sure that we give the appropriate people roles there. We're going to get close, and we're going to start sneaking. You know how we do that? By taking that thing off. We've got a stealth of 80. Hang on. This place is destroyed. Ruined Holy Nation Outpost. Ooh. Spooky. Okay, well, I'm glad that we're stealthing. Let's just, continue stealthing and let this actually properly load, and we'll see what is awaiting us inside. I'm actually just chucking a quick save because we're near the end of the episode here, and I'd hate for anything bad to happen crash wise okay, let's see. We've got a flesh cleaver here. Let's see what the flesh cleaver is like.
Okay, armor penetration is very good. Damage versus robots, damage versus humans. It's pretty good. It doesn't have a huge amount of damage though. If we're having a look at the cutting damage and the blunt damage, it's not that great of a tool. If we were able to make them ourselves, we'd be able to make them a lot better than that. There is a ninja blade here. Go ahead and pick that up for a moment, see how that compares to our ninja blade. We can just carry two. Does that mean we can dual wield? That'd be pretty cool. There really isn't all that much here. We've got some more ninja blades, some more flesh cleavers, but no sign of the Holy Nation here. So we've got to assume that maybe this was attacked some time ago. Yeah, well, let's continue on towards that way station. And I would like to make, I don't think we're going to make it to the Unknown Tower in this episode, but I think we'll make it to the tiny settlement at the very least. We'll be able to see who that settlement belongs to. It's quite the mound up this way. And which way does this lead? Straight down. Which, that way station actually seems to be kind of atop this hill. We'll probably catch sight of it in just a moment. Sant can't see it yet. But I'd have to guess it's around. Ah, and there it is. Okay, now how does one actually get up towards that? That's my next question. Let's just click on Travelers there. I think we need to go up around that way there. And that looks to be what Sand is doing. Not seeing any other creatures out here with us. I'm feeling pretty good for that. I mean, it's not goddamn beak things, so that's really good. And it looks like this is actually the easier way to go. Well, you know what you're doing, Sand. At least this place isn't destroyed. It looks like some good cats are getting spent here. So let's walk on through. We'll see what they have. Oh, advanced wind theory. Excellent. Well, I guess that was something that we maybe should have done earlier on. I didn't think that power was going to be more of an issue, and it's turned out that it is. Another battery bank complete. Ooh, you've got some nice looking turrets at the top there. And you've got another mechanics place back here as well. Quite a few. Let's have a chat with you and see what you have here. Your general stuff and things. Decent amount of iron plates. Fair amount of books. Okay. Let's head around to the other one. Didn't have anything extra special. No ancient science books that we'd want to use. Hello there, Mr. Skeleton. Look at your station you have here. You're a skeleton doctor, which means that you probably have limbs. Let's see. What is this place?
This is where skeletons can get their permanent injuries fixed up. Probably not much use to you, human. Unless, of course, the Fogman eat your legs off or something. Then maybe I could pick you some nice new ones.
Okay. Right. Let's hope that doesn't happen. Do you have anything for sale? Indeed he does. He has some very nice arms. Now, while I would hate to steal from such a nice skeleton doctor, we might not have any other choice. Although, if I had to think about it, do skeleton doctors sleep? Do skeleton doctors dream of electric sheep? If they do, we can probably break in here and try and steal some things. However, in saying that, if they do sleep, they'd be sleeping on the skeleton repair bed, which is right next to where everything else is. So that would be a monumental task for us to pull off. And while, well, you know what, we could probably do a snatch and grab. We could probably do a snatch and grab. Let's head inside here. I mean, maybe. We need it. We need it. But we can also kind of semi-afford it. That's why I feel bad. But hey, look, we're inside of a bar. Let's see if they've got anything interesting to start with. Bottle cap. Okay, nothing here. But let's see what the people are like here. You are looking very interesting. You're a plastic surgeon. We have Savano over here. Okay, we have someone from the Traders Guild. I see. Who else do we have? Looks like a whole heap of mercenaries. Yep, mercenary captain. We've got an ugly bar thug. Maybe we'll go talk to you, ugly bar thug. We've got Harun from the tech hunters over here, who is looking pretty damn good in terms of stats and everything else. The tech hunters tend to be, like mercenaries as well. We've got Pilsment, who's a drifter. Talk to Sergal. So no one's super interesting. Let's see if we can talk to our friend over here, actually. Not you. Oh, Harun. Okay. Yeah, bodyguards. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. What about the bar thugs? Oh, we could buy bar thugs as well. No, unlikely. But it is, as you can see, it's quite late. I don't actually think he's going to go to sleep. It's 4 a.m. If he was going to, he would have done that already. Can we sneak in here? We can. Now, I kind of imagine the skeleton doctor just kind of drifting a little bit. Maybe we can see that he's not entirely focusing with his eyes. So Sand is going to attempt and successfully open this thing. Oh, I see. Now, what arm was Hanbu missing? let's see. Hanbu. You are on the outer grouping here. It's your left arm. Okay. Oh, great, because that was his left arm. That was the left arm here. That was the one that we're actually after. Yeah, it's specialist. It's a specialist arm. Oh, we could also get a good leg for Ruka here. I feel bad. I mean, that's a lot. It's a lot. It's thousands of cats worth. We don't have any skeletons with us at the moment. Do we feel as bad? I feel bad. Let's check on Ruka, who should be with the inner group here. What are you missing again, Ruka? You're missing your left leg. Okay, so again, that works out quite well. It's not a specialist leg, but it's still a decent one at that. What's the one that you're actually using at the moment? Because it could be okay. It's a scout leg, so you're a little bit faster. That one there, I think, has a little bit more to it. Athletics is good. Swimming is good. Maybe we'll just stick to the arm for now. The stealing chance is 30%, so we are going to fail at this. But we can kind of try more than once. And actually, let's just make sure that is Sand that's doing it. Oh, stealing chance goes up a lot. Okay. Oh, holy sh! We did it. We freaking did it. Oh, Sand, you sly dog. Get out of town. Get out of town. God damn, this man. This magical man. Look at that. Hanbu will be happy with that. He will be happy with that. Now let's continue on towards this tiny settlement, and that's going to wrap us up for today. Oh, Sand. You have achieved some things today, my friend. Stealing from that poor, innocent, skeletal doctor. But we do what we have to do for our friends. I'm an idiot. I stole the frickin' leg. And I even stole the wrong leg. I am so stupid. How? I just imagine everyone was just shouting at me like, weren't you trying to get an arm for Hanbu, not a leg? He can't put a leg on his arm. Comedy. Oh, god damn it. And now the sun has risen, so we aren't going to have the same stealth that we had before. Quick, Sand, get back here. Come on. I can just imagine him getting so excited, getting out the store, running all the way down the hill, and then opening up his backpack and going, that's not an arm. That's a leg.
Oh, shit.
All right, okay. All right, here we go. We're gonna go sneak. Okay, it's still dark. Get back inside, buddy, get back inside. Run back over towards here. Okay, Mission Impossible time. Let's see if you can do this thing. Okay, so we got a leg. It's not even the right leg for Ruka. It's the wrong leg. Well, it is the right leg, but she needs a left leg. Oh, jeez. Okay, Ruka, it indeed is your left leg. Well, if anyone loses their right leg, we'll be looking fine, won't we? Dear Sand. Okay, buddy. So, we don't really have a lot of room anymore. We can't put the backpack on because that's going to affect our chances. We could put it back in the safe and then take out an arm. We are looking for the right arm. Yeah? It's better than having no arm. Let's be 100% sure here, because I know I'm going to screw this up now. It's his left arm. Come on, Rycon. Okay. We can actually maybe fit this thing in here. Left arm. Okay, let's see. Okay, we got caught. He's raised the alarm. We can just try and grab it now at this stage. We got caught stealing. That sucks. It sucks big time. But we're going to try again. Left arm. We got it. Okay, we just need to go now. So at this point, Sand, you just need to run. He's off. He's out. The call hasn't reached the others yet. He's calling for guards. But we are already out of here. Sand, you are a fast boy. Well, we got a leg that we didn't need. And we got an arm for Hanbu. We were successful there. I'll be damned. Okay, well, that tiny settlement is still in our future. But guys and gals, I think we are going to wrap things up there. Sand, you continue on up along that path. And that's going to wrap us up for this episode. Thank you so much for joining me once again. I've been Rycon. You have all been awesome.
And until next time, stay tuned. Thank you all for joining me for another episode of Kenshi. If you don't know it already, you can pick up the very first piece of Rycon Roleplay's merchandise featuring Leonidas Aventus, the Dragonborn himself. There will be more items added to the store in the coming months, all available at ryconroleplays.com/store. And finally, I'd like to extend a great big thank you to the patrons who continue to make this content possible.